The Singapore brand of meritocracy must ensure that nobody is left behind. How can government policies achieve this? First, government policies have to act as enablers, as ladders and bridges to provide a fair chance for everyone to move up in society, not only across families of jobs, but also over time. The government must therefore not allow meritocracy to reward narrowly, and instead broaden and make alternative routes available. As DPM Tharman once put it, multiple peaks of excellence, and if I may add, many chances of success. Second, our policies must enable self-reliance by supporting and encouraging work. We must provide all Singaporeans with the opportunity to work and do well for themselves and their families, regardless of where they are within our system of meritocracy at that point of time. This empowers individuals and families and strengthens dignity and purpose. But the government cannot stop there. It has already recognized that the workforce must be ready for future opportunities, as their current skills could become redundant. By investing in Skills Future to support the lifelong development of skills and knowledge and industry transformation map to enable our workforce to seize opportunities in the future economy. A future that, as former Minister Lim Swee Say quipped, will see workers transit from one job in one career to many jobs in many careers. This will also ensure that our meritocracy does not become a static snapshot, but a dynamic one, where everyone has the opportunity to reap success throughout his life journey. This recognizes that potential is not just realized in school, and provides the opportunity for late bloomers to realize new dreams at different stages of their lives. Ultimately, it is trust between citizens and institutions that will strengthen Singapore's brand of meritocracy. To kindle this virtuous cycle, the government must deliver on our policies and continue to actively and openly accept in matters that are sensitive, involving issues of security or commerce.